こんにちは、リス先生です。Welcome to my channel. And this video is not any lesson, but yeah, it's a lesson for those who can learn a new language like Japanese but don't want to. Okay, I'm going to convince you people to learn Japanese with 10 reasons. Okay, and if you are already learning Japanese but you are thinking of quitting it,then this is going to stop you do that. Okay, so stay with me till the end of the video because I'm not just going to show you 2 or 3 reasons but 10 reasons why literally Japanese can help you, okay? So, what comes to your mind when you think of Japan? Anime? Manga? Or samurai? Ninja Hattori, I have seen it. Or judo? Karate? Sushi? Teriyaki? Or the game shows? Or perhaps you're thinking of Doraemon, right? Okay. Or Pokemon?Hello Kitty? Or those unmentionable vending machines, okay? I know that these things is what people know about Japan. But you know what? Deep down, there's more to it than that. Japan is literally more than this, and Japanese language is also more than this. You know Mount Fuji? That's just a 1% part of Japan. Okay, I would say even less than 1%. So,Likewise, there's more to gain by learning Japanese than just anime without subtitles, okay? This was the reason the majority of people answered me, anime without subtitles, to watch anime without subtitles is the reason why we want to learn Japanese. Like, seriously. Anyway, it's not a bad reason. So, to get you even more excited about learning Japanese, here are 10 surprising benefits of choosing to learn this language, okay? So, あなたは日本語を話しますか?Okay, don't use anata wa to any formal people because it is a little more casual. So let's say you're my friend and so I'm using anata, okay? Otherwise, I would not. Okay, now it's my personal experience. I've seen many people approaching to learn Japanese, but unfortunately, they soon give up on it. Give up? Yes, give up. I really have no idea why do they do so. What is the reason?And to bring solution to it is not possible for me for the time being, but I will definitely convince you with multiple examples why can learning a language like Japanese help you. So, ready to be convinced for learning Japanese? Okay, no matter what you are a kid or you are an adult, if you are trying to learn Japanese, there's no age of learning. Remember this, okay? So if you are a 15-year-old kid or if you are a 45-year-old adult, you can still learn Japanese, okay? There's no age.So, before that, please subscribe, share, like this video, and comment below. This will really motivate me to continue this, okay? So, I would like to show you these economy ranks in the world. The first is USA, and the second is China. Third is Japan. Fourth, Germany, and fifth, UK. Okay, now, reason one comes here, and that is why I showed you that ranks, okay? Japan is having world's third largest economy. Can you believe this?I think it has become the second, if I'm not wrong. So after USA and China, Japan has been ranking third in the world in terms of economical growth. What does this indicate? Yes, there are tons of job opportunities in Japan. So if you are thinking of working in Japan and you really want to do that and you are even capable of that, you need to know Japanese, of course. And even if you don't want to learn Japanese,To have a job in Japan, you need to know that. Okay, so a basic reason is job. Job in Japan is a reason why you need to know Japanese. Okay, so reason one then, reason two. The Japanese language is the 9th most spoken language in the world. Okay, 9th most spoken language. 128 million people. I don't know this, I just Googled it. And 128 million people speak this as a first language. Okay, only in 2 countries.Okay, so globally, it is spoken by 128.3 million speakers, okay? So, why did I tell you all this, Google information? I want to tell you that Japanese is a globally recognized language. And when you speak this language, it's no less than a qualification. It's no less than a merit for you, okay? So when you know, it's not just for bragging on your friends, like, you know what? I know Japanese. Like, what? How do you say this in Japanese? No, it's really more than that. It's really, really more than that. Okay, when you know Japanese, a language like Japanese, the 9th most spoken language in the world, you really stand apart from the crowd, okay? People look at you from some expectation, and if you want to go from some interview, if people are taking the interview, you can give this as one of your qualifications, that I need to know Japanese, okay? So let's begin with the written tour. And one more thing before that, unlike other language like Spanish, French, which are taught as subjects in the school, this language, Japanese, is not taught as one of the languages, okay? It's not taught as one of the language subjects in most countries, okay? Even in USA, it's not a subject. It is like, yes, there are universities which teach Japanese, but it is not considered so important, okay? So it is not a subject. So if you know Japanese, the people will already understand that you learned it by putting extra effort from some other resources. Okay, so if you learn such a language, you will become one of those few people who learned it in spite of not having it as a subject. So this really adds to your character, okay? So it is like eye-catching. So reason 4, when you are able to learn, speak, write Japanese, you actually become more modest. Believe me, it is an improvement in your character. A country's national character is reflected in the language. And for the Japanese, they try to avoid speaking directly. Okay, they use a must form. They have two speech styles only for this reason. Okay, to be more and more polite. Okay, they care for your feelings. They are very sensitive. And they also create mistake in their honorifics. Okay, so this is actually the downside point. But anyway, what I want to say is when you speak Japanese, believe me, you will find that you are becoming more and more polite, you are becoming modest, and your character is really improving. Okay, so like when you go for an interview, people don't notice your qualifications because there are millions of people in this world who have high qualifications. But people notice that your character, your body language, the way you speak, your manners, and this is where you lack, okay, most of the times. I don't know if you do, but mostly people do. I'm telling a rough figure, people do. So this language is going to help you improve your character. Reason 5, it provides more opportunities for international understanding. Okay, now if I talk about the relationship between US and Japan, they have a lot of economic significance. Okay, and you know, it was a time when Hiroshima and Nagasaki were attacked with nuclear bombs, and today Japan and America are such good friends. Why? Economy. It's all the game of economy. So it is very critical for more and more Americans to be proficient in Japanese, okay? And it's a common language that Japanese are very nationalistic, okay? They, even though they know to speak and write any other language, they would prefer having their own texts in Japanese, okay? So English speaker can actually manage with a Japanese person, like he would prefer speaking Japanese, but the Japanese guy would never prefer speaking any other language, but he would always want to have his own language, his own texts. So it will allow you to have more opportunities for international understanding, okay? So fluency in Japan, in Japanese, will allow you to improve your communication, and it will be easier if you know the language Japanese to communicate with people. Okay, now the richness of Japanese culture is unexplainable in words. Obviously, we know that Japan is a country which is known for its culture. It is known for its amazing journey. It's not just that it's known for Doraemon or Hello Kitty, but it's really more than that. It's really more than Mount Fuji. So reason 6 why you should learn Japanese is that it will make you understand the Japanese culture. The Japanese culture is so unique that it haven't accepted the dominance of any other culture over them, okay? It's a combination of the traditional and the modern practices. If you see nowadays, people in Japan, the women in Japan, do not wear kimono, only the modern ones, okay? But when it is a religious festival, each and every single kid will wear a kimono, believe me, they do. They respect their own culture and they do not allow any other country's culture to dominate them. This is the beauty of Japanese culture, and I really respect it. Okay, so typically social conducts are not something that you will see in the West. Okay, in the West, Japanese cultures are not so prone. Okay, there are these cultures of Japanese is ingrained in the people, maybe young or maybe old. Younger generation, they will still have a little modern behaviors. Like in my case, I am a patternary Japanese person, but I do not wear a kimono, or I do not wear the Japanese traditional dresses, or I don't even have the Japanese traditional fan. Really, I just wear a normal Western clothes. So yeah, I exhibit a few modern behaviors, a few motor, like my accent is American. I'm not like my accent wise, I'm not in Japanese, but still I follow the traditions that my elders have taught me. So this is the one of the beautiful thing about Japanese culture. Now the reason seven is that you will improve your skills in studying other academic lessons. How? Like you are studying Japanese and your academic lessons are also improving simultaneously. Well, this is no less than a shock, right? Now as a student, learning Japanese will help you gain broader perspectives. You will think more highly, like your order of thinking will really improve and new learning strategies will be encountered by you. Okay, and you can apply all this in your academic subjects. Okay, I'm going to upload a video on how can language help you improve your brain. And this is scientifically proven that when you know more than one language, when you're bilingual or when you're multilingual, your brain actually works sharper than any of the other unilingual person, okay? Reason 8, you can qualify as an English teacher in Japan. Okay, now what if you don't know Japanese so good, but you know English a lot? Like, you know to speak English, you have your qualifications for that, and you want to teach English in Japan. Then how do you do that? Okay, now your proficiency in Japanese can be a stepping stone to teach English in Japan high schools or even in some local Japanese organizations of the government. Government organizations will hire you to teach English. It's no less than a golden opportunity. Please don't miss this. So how is that possible? Now when you want to teach English in Japan, you still need to know Japanese. Okay, it's mandatory. Now the Japan Exchange and Teaching Program, JET, is an annual program where foreign students who pass the criteria and review the process can stay and teach in Japan. So when you pass the criteria, I don't know much, you have to Google JET and you will find a lot of information about it. So when you pass the criteria for JET, you can teach as an English teacher in Japan for at least full 1 year. And it's like, wow. And what is the aim behind this is to increase the foreign languages in Japanese education. Okay, just like we are trying to learn Japanese, people in Japan are also trying to learn some other different languages. They want to learn English, but they are not able to because their education system is quite different than ours. And we can actually learn Japanese much easierly, okay, than they can learn English because there are so many similarities between English and Japanese. Now, you can continue to study Japanese language during your stay when you teach English in Japan, okay? So, reason 9, it's your gateway to more Asian cultures and languages. Now, as Asian languages such as Korea or China or India, they have exerted influence over Japanese history. You will find that although the Asian cultures are different, they share very similarities, and you will find that like when you learn this language, you yourself will recognize it. Okay, what are the similarities between the other Asian countries like China or Korea or India with Japan? So when you know the language like Japanese, you will really find it easy to study other languages like Korean. So Korean language has a very similar grammar to that of the Japanese language. Both have advanced honorific systems. Like I said, I forgot, my mom told me that even in her own language, they use a word, I forgot it. I gotta ask her. That word is only used for elders, then they have other word which is semi-formal, and then they have the lowest formal word. So this is the same in Japanese, right? We have a honorific system to greet higher people, then we greet our own friends or our own family with a different form of speech style. So this is even prevalent in other Asian countries. So you can literally learn other languages, Asian cultures, Asian languages when you know a Japanese language. Okay, so it will be easier for you to also learn Chinese. Like we know kanji is the Chinese characters which we use in Japanese, right? So you can have an idea that Japanese is really correlated to Chinese. So if you see this, These are the respective kanjis for love, ai, in Japanese and Chinese. So you will find that they are really similar. Not so, but you can find these strokes. These strokes are really similar, right? Okay, now the meaning, like I hope you know that kanji is based on meaning, okay? So this kanji, which you see over here on the screen for cry, for love, they are very similar in Asian languages like Korea, China, and Japanese. So when you know any of these languages, learning the other language is going to be literally easy for you, okay? So reason 10, you can be intellectually more fluent. Believe me, scientifically proven fact, when you learn a new language, the change in your brain size is observed. Your brain literally grows, the amount of neurons increases, and it's nothing but your brain is progressing and you're expanding your horizon of knowledge. So when you learn a new language, you will literally be more intelligent. Sharp. So how many more reasons do you want? Anyway, to be honest, I don't feel that you or mostly other people are studying Japanese for these reasons. Why people are studying Japanese? Do you know that? These are the reasons why they want to learn Japanese. Pathetic reason. Sushi. They want to learn Japanese because they like sushi. Then for animes, they want to watch anime without subtitles, and that is why they want to learn Japanese. For the mangas, they want to watch mangas and they want to read the mangas. That is why they want to learn Japanese. And for Train to Busan. Have you watched Train to Busan? Have you? I have watched this. So they watched Train to Busan and they were very impressed, and that is why they want to learn Japanese. And just because it sounds good. Can you believe this? Oh my god, I can stop laughing. Just because Japanese sounds good, they want to learn Japanese. Then why the hell did I show these 10 reasons and I explained this for an hour? If you want to learn Japanese for animes and mangas, where? Anyway, I hope by watching this video, you realized how is Japanese learning helpful to you. So, I would request you to please subscribe to my channel, comment, and also, it would really mean a lot to me if you could subscribe to my channel. Okay, I said this, sorry. And if you could share my channel with your friends who are also trying to learn Japanese. And also like this video. So, see you in the next lesson. Mata ne!